Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting and today I'm coming to share with you herbal journal I just created. I've been started with pretty small one. It was like half size and it was like beautifully flat, nearly like the cover down, and now it's a little bit overloaded. So I'm gonna show you what I have created, because I do love that look of vintage books, those very old, you know, office books. I did use that style here on the cover, nothing too much complicated, just this vintage look. This is that sport tape spine, because it's flexible and it's very strong. I did this beautiful stitching on that spine, and when we open it, we've got fully loaded journal. So I have used in this journal my herbal journal digital kit. There is so many beautiful flowers which you can fussy cut out. There is a few journaling pages like this one. There is many ephemeras, and I hope that you will enjoy to work with that. I will put link down below. So I'm gonna show you what I have created. Here we've got pocket, and here is pocket. I forgot to put there something, and this is opening. This is like opening space for some basic informations. We've got window pocket here, and in that window pocket I've got these circles I have shared a few days ago, and I've got here this writing space. And for this journal I have used the dies, not for all that journal, but for many of those pages. These dies are from Planner's Essentials. It's this one. It's Elizabeth Craft Design. Planner Essentials dies. And this collection, which I used in this journal, it's collection Planner Essentials 22. Here, Planner Pockets 3. And here is some number. I'm not sure if that number belongs to this. Probably yes. 1740. And it's Planner Essentials 22. Remember that, because mostly when I try to find out, it's with this number. So 22. And I really love that. And I used also, yeah, I have used also this one for tags and for few pockets. This is also Elizabeth Craft Design, Planner's Essentials, and this one it's 26. 1744, Planner Essentials 26. And it's Planner, what is that? Pockets 4. Yeah. But mostly I have used that 22, number 22. It makes these beautiful dies. It makes this pocket. So here we've got writing space. We've got writing space here and some dies I used here. Here I have created just pocket using some offcut. You will see many of these labels. These are which my son created, those kind of travelers, adventures, stickers or labels. And I used many of them in this journal. They are kind of awesome to use because they don't have to be used just for travelers journal. Here I made small butterfly embellishment. It's just like ticket, and here you can see that other die from that 24 Planner's Essentials 24. So it looks like this, and it's page here. Here is another pocket, and I used so many dies I've got with like flowers and that greenery. I just used white cardstock, color it with my inks to green. I used many shades of green color, and then I used my dies and cut out all these pieces. This is in that collection, in that herbal journal, and I used few these quotes. I think I've got these quotes on my Patreon, and I just swap the rules on my Patreon. So if you are interested to see some tutorials, go to have a look. There will be just one tier with tutorials for $15 per month, and there will be all tutorials. Tutorials will be also here on on YouTube. I will still do that. But if you wanna see more, it will be on my Patreon. So here I've got pocket behind this envelope. There is pocket in this envelope here. And I've got kind of sliding space here. Here I've used one of postmarks to do this creative like hanging thingy. Here we've got pocket. And I used the numbers. These are numbers from Birds collection, that Blue Vitti collection. We've got their sheet with those numbers. And this is another die. It's that from that 22, Planners 22 Essentials. This die. So it's creating this top of the tag and plus this like ripped paper. And also I can show you that because with this journal will be for sale. And with this journal it comes box with some more stuff. I don't wanna save it here because you know I'm not sure if I will do some herbal journal. So I've got here like to add to this journal these my favorite decorations, few decorative mini tags I have created while ago, also a few paper clips with butterflies I have created, also a few butterflies like this with the holes here. I hope you can see that, so you can actually create this hanging thing with those butterflies. And there are pockets and these circles, the words, and then leftovers, like half pictures, some cutouts, pictures like this, you know, some leftovers from this collection. This one, small envelope, another pocket, and another envelope. It's not glued yet. It's just, you know, what I have created. And this is actually that die I have used here over the top. So it cuts a piece like this. It has those ripped edges. You just need to fold it. And there is another die which cuts just this shape on the tag with the hole. So you can slide this over that another die cut. And it looks like this one. So there is few these shapes and that other stuff. So it comes with this journal. To add it to that journal, you know, once new owner will have it. So that it's like a rest what I didn't use, but I think it still belongs to that journal. So it comes together. Here, and again one of these circles I have created few days ago. Here you can see that journaling page. Here I do have opening space. I used one of those pockets, and it's pocket here, and here I've got these two tags. And here is another space for journaling. From the other side, we've got another space for journaling. One of these pages from that collection. I place it upside down this way. And here, just small layout. Here we've got pocket. And I used these papers are from the paper pad I've got. I've got on my Etsy, it's this vintage office paper pad, and in this paper pad you have so many different styles of papers. Some of these papers are in green shade or the green color, and I have designed this paper pad especially because I was thinking in the future I'm gonna do some greenery or some herbal or some, you know, flower journal, and the green color ledger papers, they will be amazing to use that. So you will see that here. I used one of these papers here for this window. I use it for all those toppers, all these toppers, because they are, you know, in that beautiful green here as well. So all these small pieces are made using those papers from that paper, but it's on my Etsy as well. Not too many. So if you are interested to buy it, go to have a look, because I don't have many left. So, and here, yeah, you saw opening here with picture inside. This is in that collection as well. And I did so many decorations. I used those cuts, these small pieces from that planner's essentials as decorations here as well. So many quotes and those dies in green color. I've got here as well quotes and some numbers and mini pad, and there is a pocket here, and we've got writing space here. And when we flip it over, we've got pocket here and some small layout and pocket here. And I created few of these, like, you know, slides. What is it? Those specimen slides. I'm not sure the right name. And I use those dies, those flower dies inside as well. And here another quote from Jacob. So this journal, it's like fully decorated. You can see I used some greenery washi tapes. This is another journaling page from my herbal journal collection. Here you can see one of these papers from this paper pad. This one. And also that paper underneath. And I saved also when I've been fussy cutting these small, you know, flowery cuts, die cuts. I've been saving also, here you can see which way I have, you know, colored my white cardstock. So I really used so many different shades of green. And then I saved those pieces. And I'm using them here like decoration as well. So some pages for writing. Small layouts on these pages, these quotes are fantastic to use. And here I use the die just, you know, over the edge. These papers are in that herbal journal as well. Here we've got another pocket and pocket in that envelope. Here it's another pocket and another that hanging thingy. It reminds me, you know, here in the UK, those old pubs, they do have that sheet with the name of the pub hanged on that holder front of, like, above the door. And it always looks so amazing. So I tried to create it here, kind of ish, just with, you know, with nature theme. And here I've got one of these dies. Or leftovers, like sliding spot. Here is pocket, so something can be put inside. And we've got another pocket here, another that quote, and I've got large pocket here. And again, I used those green office papers, ledger papers. And here I've got this, like specimen window, and I used one of these document circles in this specimen window. So it's here. Here I used this flower it gave me my son, and I saved that beautiful what is it? Don't remember name of that. Oh mine. Grass? It's not grass. Yeah, it is grass, right? So I save it, I let it dry, and I use it here like decoration, and I really like that. When you will have a look on that journal, how that greenery is peeking out, it's so cute. And that idea I got in my head just because a while ago I saw so gorgeous journal made by Nick the Booksmith with her forest journal. That was amazing book. I still remember that. And she made that book that the leaf leaves was peeking out from those pages. It was so good. So I just used this one. I was thinking, maybe it will be peeking out a little bit. And it looks really amazing. So it's peace my son Jacob gave me. And here I've got small notepad. And again, one of these labels. Here is a small pocket. Another this specimen glass. I have no idea how to call that. It's here. So writing space, another writing space. And I've got, this can be used like bookmark. It's just left over from that green office paper. You can see it's beautiful green. It's not, it's not too bright. It's nice green. So I really like to use it here. And we've got tag here and space for journaling, space for journaling. Here is another paper from this collection, that journaling paper. And here I've got writing space and tag behind. This is another top tag from these dies, Planner's Essentials number 24, this one. Here I have created pocket. And here you can see the other die for that... those toppers, where is it? For those toppers here, it's just small die which creates this top. So then you not just need to take that, that small piece, fold it over and glue it together and you will have decorative top. And here, I'm gonna take this first. I've got another that specimen window. I used also my other distress inks and I distress it or color it with other colors as well to make it a little bit more interesting. Here is another of those green office papers from that paper pad, and it's just like writing long writing space. And I've got pocket here, and these pockets I have created with those papers as well. From that paper pad, these ones. Same is here, pocket here. So this journal, it's kind of overloaded, I guess. Here I used one of these postmarks just to decorate this top. And I can hang it this way, or because I didn't glue it properly, like totally to the end, I can like slide something behind. So I can slide it here, this way, over the edge. And here we've got journaling space. On this other side, it's journaling space. And here I've got just a small booklet for writing, again with green paper. This paper, it's from my old ledger paper. I showed you long time ago. It's a very large book. This one, it's like really very large book with all those beautiful old ledger papers, and few of them was like loose, so I'm still using them, those few which was loose. I'm not gonna cut that book probably ever because I love that book. So here we've got writing space. Here is another mini page, and I created small pocket here. This can be open, so maybe some small information put here or right here. And here I've got just this picture. Yeah, and piece of that office paper. And here mini notebook. And I've got another pocket here with another those specimen slides. Not sure if it's specimen slide or specimen window or a specimen glass. Not sure the right word. And here I made another small layout and this tag. Here another small layout using those quotes. I will put all links for all digitals I used here down below. This is in that collection, in that herbal journal, and here I have created, another tag for writing, and this can be unfold. Hey! Oh, come on. Don't. So it can be unfold this way and slide back. like this. And I've got one of these circle numbers here. And again, opening, we've got pocket here. And small quote here. And pocket here. There is loads of space where you can still add so many small pieces. You can write here, place something here. It's so many pockets still here. I do have something in those other pockets, but not in all of them. Here we've got like a small opening, writing space, and it's like pocket behind. And I've got another that circle decoration. Here, one of my butterfly, handmade butterfly paper clips. And this tag, and it's on this writing page. So I'm gonna clip it back. Oh, come on. This way. And here I've got another small booklet. And here is like holding spot, and decorated with these small pieces, and it's writing space here. And I didn't glue that that edge of that die, so something can be slide behind as well. And here we've got some greenery, green page, and I've got here this tag. So I did fussy cut out quite loads of these small green flowers, like a lot. They are everywhere. Here is pocket and a small tag, and here is just small decoration. And I have created these mini envelopes using those papers from that office paper pad. So if you like to create herbal journal, or you know, some nature style journal, I believe these papers will be exactly what you will like in your journals. And I've got here this teeny mini small envelope. It's slide behind this quote. Pocket is here, so there is really lots of space. Here I've got one pocket, and again some quote, and I've got mini tag with this hanging thingy. This is from Czech Republic. It's from clothes, actually, this one. And here we've got a sliding spot, and it can be opened this way. And I've got large tag here. And here you can see another of these green office papers from that paper pad. And we've got pocket here. This is in this collection as well. And small layout here. Here is another that window pocket, and I've got there another this specimen tag with hanging this small circle tag. Oh, come on, go. And another quote from Jacob. And here on the other side, here you can see another from these papers from that office, vintage office paper pad, and this can be open like this, so there is writing space and pocket here. In that pocket I've got this mini booklet or book page, and it's holding with this rusty paper clip. Here we've got pocket. I'm gonna add there one tuck pocket here, and hanging over the edge it's this mini tag with that numbered tag, and another quote. So it's here. I'm gonna just slide it there. And we've got another page with small booklet. And this is just simple decoration. And I've got this booklet here for writing. I'm gonna place it back. And from somewhere I took this one. I don't remember where it was. I'm gonna just place it here. It's just pocket, large pocket for saving something interesting. So I'm gonna place it here. I don't have no idea where from I took it. So we've got another small book page writing space here. This is another from those journaling pages from that herbal journal. Another small tag. And tag here. And here over the edge, I showed you a few weeks ago how I have created this mini booklet. So because I did use those green colors, I'm using it here like decoration over this tag, just hanging here like this. And I really like that tag, the green, it's just matching all together. And here we've got like sliding spot, so something can be put there. And I've got pocket here with mini notepad. And I think, it got glued. You think I glue it? Yeah, I glue it, you know, on purpose to slide there. I wanted to slide there a small tag like this. I forgot. So we've got mini notepad here. We've got pocket here. In that pocket, it's this one. Hey, go there. Okay, I'm gonna place you there this way. Or not. And it can be open and there is just small decoration. Same, it's here on this writing space. Another book page from old herbal book. Here I have used one of these quotes like slide spot, and I've got there this tag. And here on the top I have used another postmark, just like creation. And here on the top, it's another from my homemade butterfly paper clips. When we flip it over, it's just, you know, this divider card. And here I've got neat some tags. Look at me. I've got pocket here and pocket from that other side. And again, this hanging thingy. And I really love that. And here we've got another opening space. We will be nearly on the end. And in that pocket, I've got this ephemera. This is in the journal as well. So it's in that pocket here. Writing space here. Pocket here. Here in this pocket, I've got small booklet. This is in that herbal journal, like ephemera as well. Here another large pocket. And I used again those green office papers from this paper pad. Opening here with small decoration, and again mini notepad here, pocket here. Here I've got another that left over, and with another left over, it's just hanging here like decoration. And it's writing space. So there is so many writing spaces. Hey, come on, we've got tag spot here and another tag spot here, book page. Yeah, and that stuff in that box, it's for these pages which I didn't decorate too much here and there. I just left it the way I like it, but I think that new owner maybe will like to add there a little bit more. So I've got, this is another page from that journal. Here another greenery. We've got pocket here. We've got pocket here, and I think I will add a few of these tags to that box as well. And we've got writing space here, and I've got here this index card, like a booklet with correspondent card on the top. And I just place it this way, and on the top I've got another leftovers from that cutting. And it's just like decoration here, just like this. And we've got another opening here with this beautiful picture, and I made it just like booklet. So it's here. Oi. Okay, go there. Good. And it's pocket from this side. And in this pocket I've got another letter. And it's in this collection as well, in that herbal journal. And here I've got another window pocket and another booklet. So there is so many things. And it can be so many art inside, because there is really loads of pockets and spaces where you can add your text. And once these papers will kind of sit down, I do believe here you've got another dot of greenery from my Jacob with small quote, and another space for journaling with small booklet with checklist. So it's just over the edge. I've got another butterfly here, same it's here, book page, and here we've got another journaling page from that herbal journal. I've got here this is ephemera from this collection, and here another ephemera from this collection. It's like a envelope. So it's here, and I'm holding it all with another rusty paper clip. And we've got tag spot here with small booklet, and this can be maybe used like tag spot. Yeah, it can, or you can just flip it over and write something there and flip it back. I'm gonna leave it there. And another that hanging thingy with mushrooms. Here I've got small booklet. This is in that collection as well. And we are nearly on the end. Here I've got opening pocket like this, and in that pocket I've got one of these passports. So here I have created passport with pocket here and with pocket here. So I've got a like mini book with pockets. So I've got it here is pocket, and it's closing with this string. And I've got pocket behind here, and in that pocket behind I've got this postcard, but I'm using it like a booklet. Oh, what was that? Ah, tack. Okay, so it's here, and this can be opened this way, and I've got another ephemera here, and I hope we are on the end. Kind of long process to show you this book. It's like overloaded. Oh, nearly. Yeah, this is last pocket. Good. So I've got small booklet here, and the last thing in this journal, it's pocket here, and it can be open like this, and it's pocket here. In that pocket there I've got this booklet this way. And it's in that herbal journal. This is in that herbal journal as well. And I've got inside this private mailing card and small index card, like index card booklet. All, not all, but one more slider. One more slider. And which way I can show you? This way, maybe? One more slider. And I used again my coloring skills. And I did use so many this time, so many different colors of my distress inks. That was good. So this is my sharing of my herbal journal. This herbal journal will come with this box. I'm gonna add there straight away a few more these mini tags. So a few more these mini tags. So this will be for sale if anyone of you will be interested to buy it. I'm not sure how fast I will be to post it on my Etsy. If it will be not there, please contact me on my email. I will left the email down below, or on Messenger on Facebook. But I will place it on my Etsy soon. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for sharing your time with me. I will put all links down below, including for this paper pad. If you like to create, you know, some greenery, some nature style journals, I believe these papers will be good. Thank you so much for visiting me today. Have a wonderful day. Take care about yourself and see you next time. Bye.